dum da da dum da da dum da da dum da 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 dum da da dum da da dum da da dum da 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 da.
Where are we? What the hell is going on? Spin me round again and rub my eyes. This can't be happening. Amiss with people would stop to hold their heads heavy and some notes came falling at your mouth. It's sweet talk news, people would cut people us would cut speak us. No feeling, no, I don't believe you.
It definitely became a part of the way I was able to interact with other people.
I started doing pot when I was 15. I did from pot from 15 to 17. And 17, I started doing other stuff. Like I tripped out on acid once when we were snowboarding back at Mount Snoqualmie. Like this is the best time ever.
Actually, every drug I ever did or alcohol, I hated the first time I did it. So I did it again.
I kept struggling with this addictive sexual behavior that I couldn't stop.
But then I wanted to die. You know, towards the end I wanted to die. I wanted to get high or die. Whichever. I didn't care.
The alcohol, it came in, it was more about an emotional escape.
I mean, it just really affected me, really fucked me up.
There was a time when it was a love relationship. It was my best friend, and then it became my worst enemy.
You know, in the beginning it was fun and exciting, and it was you know, something to explore, something to, you know, a place to go, or kind of getting high and getting drunk and getting high and drunk whenever I wanted to, is how much I wanted to. Like,
it's difficult to be around, and it's difficult to see that the pain, you know, or the depression, or the personal resentments, or the fact that they, you know, they use these drugs because they feel that's the only way that they can actually act out.
It was just a nonstop party, beer drinking, smoking weed, and I got tired of it. I got tired of it.
I think it's almost a way of life. I know that it was for me.
The way I was able to interact with other people and not worry about what they thought about me.
I didn't know where I was. I was tripping out all the time. And so that was really a killer drug that just messed me up big time.
I don't know why I did drugs. I just did them.
And somewhere in there, I lost myself completely and found myself, you know, homeless on the streets. lost contact with my family, lost contact with friends that cared about me. So that relationship definitely took me, you know, to a place where I never thought I would ever recover from.
And it just like gave me the courage just to go up to someone and just like shake their hand and introduce myself.
I just had this tingling sensation over my body, which I loved.
You know, it's like, this is fun, but this is crazy. This is fun and this is intense. And 3 days later, okay, I thought I was supposed to go to sleep now. It's like, I can't get to sleep, you know? And so there's that insanity.
The sex addiction, it can be so brutal. It's brutal. There's a real brutality and an aggression about sex addiction that can be masked sometimes as, oh, I'm having fun, this is what gay men do, and, you know, I'm really connecting, and this is what I'm supposed to be doing.
Like, I used crystal meth every day for about 4 years, and somewhere in there, I acquired HIV.
Apparently, I drank so much that night that I ended up at the bathhouse. I woke up, and there were a bunch of used condoms on the floor of my room.